So what I'm going to do now is to have a go installing two Office programs. I think they're GNOME related, I'm not sure. But they're sort of not basic, but they're not as advanced as LibreOffice. I think they're still quite feature rich. So the first one's a word processor, and the second one's a spreadsheet. It looks like they are from the GNOME. Well, that one isn't a GNOME project, but the numeric one is a GNOME utility. So we'll start with Abiword. It's got a couple of dependencies. Some WV. That message say. Alright, didn't say anything. So extract. Why is that not downloading? Like that's not downloading, so let's open up the file in a different tab. Alright, okay. Looks like the package can't be found, so let's search for the package name. I guess it's Oregon State University. I've got mirror of all the BLFS stuff. Okay, that's the document that we're already looking at. Actually, if we open that in a new tab again and then just see if we can edit this and find our way manually. So we'll go to pub, LFS packages. Well, this is going to be the normal Linux from scratch, but looks a bit, unfortunately. Maybe the BLFS, yep. 9.1. We want WV. There it is. So that's working. Let's just check the MD5 sum. I'll just read it. I won't save it. So let's do MD5 sum WV and it's DDB. Well, in fact, we can copy this, just paste it underneath here. And yeah, it's identical. So let's get rid of that and extract it. Install it. What I'm going to do is go back here, just bookmark that. And it looks like it's a straightforward install. And sudo multi-make install. And that's WV, which is in chapter 9. So now I want GOffice. Looks like we've got all of that. So again, it's just a straightforward. Oh, in fact, looks like we've got documentation we can build, so let's do that. And let's build. Okay, now let's run make check. That's all good, so let's install now. And that's GOffice done. So that's in chapter 25. GOffice. So now we're back to Abiword. Let's download it. And some documentation here. To enable many of the optional dependencies, review the information from configure help. So they're not actually giving us any here, no. Apart from enable plugins. So let's do this sed first. Oh, it's still downloading the looks of it. Oh, so this is, maybe there's something wrong with the Abiword website then. So let's get these both from the Oregon State University. We'll find out where the bookmarks are. Is this it here? What was that? Bookmarks right in front of me. So A for Abiword 304 and Abiword Docs. Abiword 304, and Abiword docs. That's better, a bit faster. So we've got this said, so yep, that should go in. Then it says do configure help. Enable plugins. Okay, yeah, there is a lot of plugins there. So let's do the configure prefix it will use. Oops. Add in the plugins that they've suggested here. Grammar one requires an external package, so we'll get rid of that one. Then there's a few options up here. I think we've got that. Got GIO. I suppose with GOffice is the same as the plugins, maybe. Specify it anyway, we just installed it. Don't know what that is. Redland we've got. We've got the Evolution data server. We've got libical and we've got Champlain as well. What else have we got? Libgcrypt. Probably not much else out there, so let's try it and see if that configure works. Okay, good, we've got a summary, I was hoping we would do. Optional features, menu button. Clip art and templates. Wonder how we enable them, you would have thought that would be quite important to have. Optional features. Right, enable menu button. Clip art and right, so let's add those three switches as well. So enable menu button, enable clip art, enable templates. Okay, that looks better, so let's try and make this. Oh, it's failed straight away, so obviously it didn't like something we tried to build. Let's do make minus J1 to see the error easier. EV Unix menu. VBox. Is that that WV we just loaded? Let's see if that makes any difference. No. Browser. Can't find it. So what I'll do is go back to configure, and perhaps should have done this in the first place. Just try a very basic configure and see if that configures. Find out which ones of these fails. Perhaps it's a case of trying to run fork and walk. I should have probably tried this wrong way around, didn't I? I should have done. Yeah, make clean. What I should do is start with everything and knock things off. Feeling. Oh, I wonder if it's that known VFS actually. Let's remove that. Let's build it, see what happens, see how far it gets. No, so it wasn't that. Let's try the GIO. It's not the GIO. let's just go through all of them. Let's try the, without the G office. Even though it specifies G office as a requirement. Actually, to be quite honest, I should be cleaning up in between each one. Let's do my clean. Start with GIO again. So we know that known VFS doesn't work with a clean tree. Let's try moving the GIO again. So it's not that. Let's make clean again. So let's try removing the with G office. Although I can't believe it would be that one. Okay. So now let's remove with Redland. No, that's failing. Now let's try removing the evolution data server. Right, so it's not that one. Hoping it's not going to be the last one we take off. So with libical. That one. So with Champlain next. Oh, that's funny, it's still using. I've just noticed these optional dependencies, so it's obviously not cleaning these things out properly, is it? Let's try and make this clean. Maybe that's what I should have been using. Right, go back again. Right, I'm going to start right from the top with known VFS. No, I'm not, because that was from a brand new source tree that we expanded. So let's try it with GIO again. Trouble is I can't tell from there. Just a disk clean. Alright, okay. So let's just try the make then. Oh, it looks like disk clean that is too severe. Risk losing that configure command, so I'm just gonna run it so I don't lose it out of the history. So this shows that cleaning doesn't always, well, A, rerunning the configure doesn't always reset everything, and neither does cleaning, which is why it's usually better to start from scratch. Didn't take that long to extract it anyway. So, the only thing is I need to do the sed command, don't I? So, let's do it with the sed command with all the options to start off with, just so you know where we are. Let's run make, which we expect to fail, and it has done. So let's go back and remove Abiword 3, expand it again. Plug this set in as well. Oh, 304. So RM minus RF Abiword 304 and expand it, then want to CD into Abiword 304. Right, that's better. Now I can recall that configure command. And now I'll move it with GIO. run make. Okay. So cd dot dot and. Right, I can recall the visual configure. Let's remove with office, with GOffice. So this time I'm doing each option on a fresh expansion of the source package. So make, and it's still failing. Now we'll remove with Redland. Do the evolution data server. Build it. Oh wait, there's still something wrong here, because the config had the evolution data server there. Yes, what am I doing wrong? Oh, but some of these were being found, weren't they, I think. So I just need to carry on, I think. So this is with libical missing. I wonder if it's one of the last three that I've added in that weren't actually in the list. That's probably what it is. Yeah, I bet that's what it is. The ones that have automatically been found are working. When it's searching. Right, in that case, I'm going to do it from the end of the configure this time. So I've done up to libical, so let's remove the templates first. It's these last three that come up no, which I've added in to force it to yes. I reckon one of them, if not all of them, is failing. So it's not that one. Just going to remove the next one. Oh, So it's got to be this one here, I think, then. So we're back to where we were originally with no menu button, clip art, or templates. Let's see if this starts to build. Yeah, it has done. So is it that menu one then? Or is it just any of them? Let's find out. So this time I've got all the options back. I'm going to remove the enable menu button and see how this goes. It may just fail later on because of the one of the other two options that I've left in. So I can see menu button's not enabled, so let's see. So menu button was the one that was causing it to fail. So the next question is, will the other two options cause it to fail or not? Okay, that's actually built successfully. So it's that one menu button option that was causing the configurator or the build fail. So let's install it now. And then we can build the documentation. And install it. And configuration says choose the right template for your language and locale. So it looks like for me it's going to be that one there. Create the folder Abi Suite and then copy the normal AWT you want into it. So the one I want is that plus ENGB. And there's a bit there about deja vu fonts, run the update desktop database. Actually, I won't do that because it will override the Office, LibreOffice, and I don't want to do that. And something here for the icons. So that should be installed. So let's see if we find that here. Yep, there it is. And there you go, there's a page waiting, unusual kind of, well, it's a sort of more advanced text editor, I suppose. There's a few options and things, not as advanced as LibreOffice, but certainly a step on from just a text editor. So that's that one. It's just to help about. And I was wondering about the GNOME Office as well. What's that doing? All right, okay, it's opening a dead web page with the looks of it. So that's Abiword done. So I'll mark that off in the list.